I was gonna get married one day, right? And when I was about to get married, like the day I was gonna get married, I decided not to.
Oh, what? Oh. Why?
I told the guy, you know, look, this is not gonna work, so I'm just not gonna get married. And anyway, I was paying for everything.
You're like the runaway bride.
See, I was paying for everything, so it doesn't matter.
Spanish by birth, but Mexicana by heart. Please welcome the incredibly talented Natalia Jimenez.
Yay! Thank you. Thank you, everybody.
Mexicana is right. You look at your flowers.
Yeah, this is like Mexican and Spanish. You know, we have all these things in common. So it's like, you know,
a little bit of both.
Yeah, it's like a bit of a homage to everybody.
I love that. Now you have a new project coming up.
Yes.
Can you tell us about it?
Well, I have a new album that it's called Mexico de mi Corazón, and it's like a mariachi album. So I'm known for singing pop and rock and stuff like that, but it's been a long time coming. I've, you know, wanted to do this album forever, and I decided to do it now. You know, I had a two-year-old, two and a half. Right now, she's two and a half. She's crazy. She drives me nuts. So I decided, you know, to go on tour.
What a great thing to do.
So I'm like, and what better way to do it than releasing a mariachi album that it's all party and fiesta and let's go and have fun, you know?
That is so funny. And does your daughter like listening to the music?
She's amazing, man. She loves music, and, you know, she's always asking me to play songs in the ukulele, and she's super cute. She's super cute.
That's so adorable. Now, you're talking about you've wanted to release this for a long time. Mm-hmm. So what was the moment for you when you're like, okay, I'm going to do it now?
Well, I don't know. It was like a year ago or so that I was like, okay, so it's time for me to release a new album. You know, I haven't been, you know, in contact with music and stuff, you know, and I was writing and I was like, man, this is boring. This sucks, you know, and I could not find anything that I liked. So I said, well, you know, why don't I just do what I always wanted to do?
Yeah.
And I called my A&R from Sony Music Mexico and Latin, and they said, you know, that's a pretty good idea, you know? So we did this live album. It's like a primera fila format, like an unplugged.
Oh, wow.
And we have El Mariachi Gamamil, which is one of the best mariachis in Mexico, you know? You know, this is Mexican things, you know? We have these mariachis that are amazing, and that's one of the best. And we're singing, you know, the classical songs from, like, I don't know, Juan Gabriel, Solís, José Alfredo, Rocío Dúrcal, all these amazing people. I'm so excited. I can't wait.
Oh, my God. Yes. And I love that you have so much passion for the Mexican culture. How did that come about?
Well, I'm from Spain. I'm from Madrid, because a lot of people don't know me right now. So I'm from Spain. Right. I'm from Spain. I'm from Madrid. And I used to have this band called La Quinta Estación, right? Uh-huh. It's the fifth station. Not the season, the station. So we moved from Madrid to Mexico because we got this record contract, right? Mm-hmm. And they wouldn't sign us in Spain. They didn't care about us. They didn't give a crap about our music. So we moved over to Mexico, and we crossed the ocean, and we started living there. And we released our first albums and stuff, and I just loved it. I loved living there. I loved the food. I loved the people. I loved the music. I loved the city. You know, there's a lot of people that say that, you know, Mexico is dangerous, that Mexico is this and that, but, you know, I lived there for almost 10 years, and I've never been happier. Like, I live here in Miami now, in the States, and I miss it dearly.
Like, do you think you'll ever go back?
When I go back all the time to work and stuff, and I left because, you know, I had to get married and
stuff. I had to get married.
To do list.
No, it's funny, because in Espanol digo, pues me eché a perder, ¿no? Y me fui, me casé, y pues ya, you know, but...
But you waited a while, about to get married, didn't you?
I waited because, you know, this is funny. I was gonna get married one day, right? And when I was about to get married, like the day I was gonna get married, I decided not to.
Why?
I told the guy, you know, look, this is not gonna work, so I'm just not gonna get married. And anyway, I was
paying
for everything.
You're like the runaway bride.
See, I was paying for everything, so it doesn't matter. So I decided the next time I'm just gonna wait, you know? So now that we were together for like 7 years before getting married, okay. And then we got married.
So earlier in the show, we were talking about, taking your time in a relationship or if you move too fast. Yes. So obviously you're an advocate for moving a little slower.
Yes. Move slower. Slower than you think that slower is good. O sea, más despacio de lo que piensas que despacio. O sea,
but you guys work together, don't you?
Huh?
You guys work together. Don't you work with your husband?
Yes. Yeah. He used to work with me. He used to be my manager. Now I changed my management because since I had the baby and stuff, it's like
somebody's
we don't have time.
Somebody gotta be home.
Good. I didn't have time to have the baby, the management company, my concerts, his producing because he produces TV. It's crazy. So I said no, bro.
So do you miss working with him?
No, not really.
No,
because when you work with your husband, it's you never get a break, you know.
Yeah.
So it's
always
cool that we get a break from working all the time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You know. Now I miss him, so it's great because I'm like, oh man, I miss you. I've been out for a week.
Welcome back to Get It Girl. We're going to get to know Natalia Jimenez a little better through a little game.
Yupi!
We'll bring up an experience and subject and you tell us what you have or haven't done.
Okay, cool. Okay.
All right. Have you ever dated a person your parents hated?
Yes, of course.
Green.
Everybody has done that, but I think that your parents hate everybody you date, no? Anyway,
they're never good enough.
Yeah, they're never good
enough. Your parents are like, they want the best for you, so.
Yeah, and then the one that they like, you're like kind of awkward about it, yeah, right?
Yeah.
But do you keep dating them even though your parents don't like them?
Claro.
Yeah?
Yeah. Claro, solo por molestar, you know?
I know.
Well,
guess
what? At the end, they were right.
And then
they're right. Claro.
It's so true. You just have to learn the hard way. Why are we so complicated?
Yeah, right? Okay, next question.
It's
Have you ever gone through your significant other's phone?
No. Which significant other? Past ones or actual?
Past ones, yes.
Old ones.
Well, past ones, yes.
Yeah.
And that's why we're not together.
Yeah. Right? What did you find?
Oh, girl, like, we need a whole segment.
He
was texting this girl from work, and I confronted him, and he goes, she's like my sister, we're friends, don't freak out.
Oh,
they have a one-year-old baby now.
Oh, wow.
they're best friends.
You know who I'm talking about.
Well,
they're best. So she's like my sister. Oh, really? That's nasty.
So you say you haven't done it with your husband?
No, with my husband, because, you know, like, we have, like, the password thing, so I can get through his phone.
The trust is there. I have your password.
No, and I'm cool. Like, he's married to me. He can run.
Yeah. So.
Somebody says, how you doing? You go, like, I'm great. How are you?
I'm cool. I'm married to this guy. How you doing?
You're a yes or no?
No.
No.
No. I just trust.
Yeah.
I just trust them. And
I
then
think that's important.
One day I don't anymore, so I'm out. Yeah,
it's so true. Cause I feel like I know friends that they have their husband's passwords, they have their boyfriend's passwords, and they check it regularly. And to me, I'm like, no, I wouldn't like that.
I can't check my husband's phone. He me mata. Really, like we're always together. So if he tries to do something, how is he gonna do it? Like, is he gonna go like where?
To the kitchen.
Like to the right. We're always together.
Okay, so next question: have you ever been arrested?
No.
Me neither.
No.
All right.
Okay.
No. We're good.
I've been stopped by the police though, and then I went on a date with him.
Oh.
Remember me?
Oh wow. How did it go?
We're not together.
Okay.
It was fun.
Esto como que se te quema la casa y te lias con el bombero, ¿no? This is like your house burns down and you date the fire guy.
Yeah, that would be better. I got stopped because I was on my bicycle and my light went out and he stopped me for like 15 minutes.
And then I see, sure, he stopped you for the light.
Oh, you have a cute smile. I
I was like, okay, let's go on a date. And he totally was.
Oh my God. You asked, pero tú, pero descarada tú. Qué descarada.
Got arrested almost.
Oh my God, she's failing. You got arrested in the bedroom.
Hey. Okay, next question.
She's like, okay,
okay, so next question. Have you ever dated more than one person at the same time?
No. Ooh. No, because one guy is too much work already.
O sea, she's yes.
Nobody knows this.
Yes. Yes. Oye, they don't know who they are.
Qué suerte esta, qué suerte tiene esta.
I'm going to get bad karma.
Did you end up choosing one of them, or did you break up with both?
Yeah, I chose one of them, but then I broke up with him, like, very quickly
so
after.
So you ended up
to
like
me,
not.
It was, well, I was in a relationship that just was like, I don't know why we were together. It was
pero
like,
niña, pero tú mandas a todos de paseo, hija.
Tú just like everybody.
You fire everybody.
You're fired.
You're fired.
Are you still with one of the guys?
Oh, no. It wasn't like
No.
It wasn't like real relationship. We're just going out and just hanging out. Not really like relationship. We're just, okay, I'm not busy. What are you doing?
If we're talking about dating, then duh.
Yeah.
Dating, you can date other people. Yeah. It's when you become this exclusive. Then that needs to stop.
Exactly, yes. Right?
Because what I did
good,
stop.
Good Catholic girls. Okay, last question, the hot one. Have you ever pole danced?
Pole dance?
No, I wish.
I want to. Yeah.
It's hard.
You don't have a pole in your room? Like, put it up.
No, but it's hard to hold yourself up.
Take a pole class, pole dance class.
I need more muscles.
No. I hold the pole sideways. I'm a boom pole holder.
How did you?
I was going to say something completely inappropriate.
Well, I'll say it. Now you already started.
No, I'm not going to say it, but yeah.
Playing around like you
know. Wow, just got poles everywhere we go.
Yeah. Well, I guess I'm a bad girl then.
I've never done that.
No.
I haven't.
We ended on a good question, guys. Yeah. You know what? This was so much fun, and thank you so much, Natalia.